Hello, I hope you're doing well. Welcome to this new video in which we will explore the culture of eggplants, step by step, including how to prune the plants to get good-sized fruits and a bountiful harvest. Don't forget to subscribe if you enjoy this type of content. I'll also be bringing you videos directly from the garden very soon. Many of you have already subscribed to the channel, and I really appreciate it, thank you. So, I've decided to do the same as on my French channel and give away prizes, often packs of organic seed packets, every time a subscriber milestone is reached. I'll be doing random draws for 500, 1000, 5000, 10,000, and every subsequent increment of 10,000 subscribers. To participate, it's simple. Just subscribe to the channel and leave a comment under a video. I'll then randomly select winners from the comments. Good luck, and thank you again for your support. Without further ado, let's start the video. Enjoy! 1. Presentation. Eggplant, Solanum melongena L., is an annual vegetable plant belonging to the Solanaceae family, much like tomatoes or peppers. Likely originating in India, eggplant exhibits a wide diversity with numerous varieties ranging from longer to shorter forms and from white to purple-red hues. Its cultivation dates back to 4,000 years BCE in China, but it was Arab sailors who introduced it to the Mediterranean basin, where it thrives today. As a fresh vegetable, eggplant is one of the least calorie-dense, providing only 18 calories per 100 grams. It is also highly hydrating. Consuming the skin of eggplants, rich in fibers and antioxidants, is recommended. To preserve its nutritional qualities, it is advisable to cook eggplant with a minimal amount of fats, which also enhances its digestibility. When choosing eggplants, it is generally best to select those that are firm, with smooth and shiny skin, displaying a beautiful deep purple color. The shine is a primary freshness indicator, as is the firmness of the stem, which should not be dried out. Two. Soil and climate. Soil. Eggplants thrive in deep, well-drained, nutrient-rich soil enriched with well-decomposed compost and horse manure. A fertile soil structure with good drainage is essential to prevent excess moisture. Watering needs. Eggplants have relatively high water requirements. Maintaining adequate soil moisture is crucial for promoting healthy growth and fruitful production. Climate. Eggplants flourish in a warm, sunny, and sheltered climate. They are sensitive to frost and do not thrive during cold periods. In warmer climates, a single plant can yield between 10 to 12 fruits, while in northern regions, the yield may be limited to 4 to 6 fruits due to less favorable climatic conditions. A well-exposed sunny location is therefore crucial for optimal yield. 3. Sowing and planting. The sowing. In warm climates, sow in a sheltered location in February and transplant outdoors in April. In other areas, sow on a warm bed in late February and set out in the latter half of May, after the last frost. Plant the seeds just slightly below the surface, 0.4 to 0.8 inches is sufficient. The planting. Dig a hole about 7.9 inches deep and thoroughly loosen the soil for maximum aeration. Add compost to your soil, 50% compost, 50% soil. You can also incorporate some fertilizer pellets into your mix. Personally, I use organic fertilizer. Space your plants 19.7 inches apart in rows, leaving 19.7 inches between rows. Set up your stake before planting to avoid damaging the roots when placing it in the ground. Plant the seedling until it is about 2 inches above the soil line. Backfill with your mixture, tamp down around the root ball, and water generously. If possible, create a small basin around the plant to retain water for future watering. 4. Pruning. To start, you should regularly remove any yellowing leaves and suckers that develop at the base of your plant. As for shaping the plant, it is recommended to pinch the main stem after the appearance of the first two flowers, image 1. These pinchings will promote the enlargement of the fruits. Next, allow only 4 lateral branches to develop, which you will also pinch above the second flower, image 2 and 3. This way, you will optimize your harvest with 8 to 10 well-sized fruits per plant. Five, watering. Maintain the freshness of your soil through regular yet moderate watering. It is preferable to opt for small daily waterings rather than a heavy watering followed by soil drying out. Ideally, the surface of your soil should never be completely dry. Maintaining consistent moisture will promote the growth and fruiting of your plant. It is also advisable to use mulch, such as straw or simply grass clippings from your garden, to retain moisture at the base of your plant. 6. Fertilization. Fertilizing with a blend of natural fertilizer, such as vegetable fertilizer, and compost in late fall or early spring is ideal before planting eggplants. To enhance the growth of your eggplant plants, feel free to apply tomato fertilizer once or twice during the growing season and fruit development. 7. Diseases and treatments. Eggplant, like most fruits and vegetables, is prone to some diseases and attacks by pests. Eggplant blight. Like other solanaceous plants, it is regularly affected by blight. Blight is one of the most common diseases in eggplants. Warmth combined with a certain level of humidity leads to the development of this fungus. Be sure to provide ample spacing between your plants for good ventilation. During watering, avoid wetting the foliage as it promotes the development of diseases. As a curative treatment, only the destruction of affected eggplant plants can prevent the spread of blight. As a preventive measure, regular spraying with Bordeaux mixture can help prevent the disease. Eggplant and red spider mites. Conversely, in dry weather, there may be attacks by red spider mites. Eggplant leaves can then be covered with grayish spots before turning red, brown, or yellow. Favorable conditions for red spider mites. Red spider mites proliferate and attack plants when the atmosphere is warm and dry. This is why they are found indoors throughout the year and in gardens during the summer when it is not raining and the temperature is consistently above 20 degrees Celsius, 68 degrees Fahrenheit. Furthermore, spiders are not insects, and the overuse of insecticides allows them to thrive. By killing their predators, you provide them with the opportunity to multiply. Symptoms of red spider mites. Their small size makes them difficult to see with the naked eye, but a small magnifying glass often helps identify them. The first characteristic is the appearance of small white or yellow spots, followed by the complete yellowing of the leaves. Moreover, the fact that they weave small webs around the leaves makes them easier to notice. Spray water on the plant and observe if webs appear. Treatment for red spider mites. Regularly spray non-calcareous water on the foliage to create a humid environment conducive to making them disappear. If this is not sufficient, purchase a miticide, available at any garden center. While red spider mites often cause limited damage, monitor your plants regularly, especially during hot and dry weather, as this is when they reproduce the fastest. Aphids and eggplants. Less common but equally destructive, aphids can attack eggplant crops. Aphids are formidable insects that target leaves and extract sap. This eventually causes the leaves to curl and stick together. Ladybugs. By consuming aphid larvae, ladybugs naturally contribute to aphid control. This method is increasingly used by landscaping professionals and is entirely organic. Nettle or fern slurry. Readily available in gardening stores or easily made at home. This is an excellent organic method to combat aphids. Soapy water. Made with black soap or Marseille soap, melted in water and sprayed on the plant. Soapy water prevents aphids from adhering to the leaves. Dissolve 150 grams of grated soap and 1 tablespoon of oil in 1 liter of water, then spray it onto the plants. Plants repellent to aphids. Planting repellent species like nasturtiums, marigolds, and especially lavender helps naturally ward off aphid invasions. Eight. Good companionships. To optimize the cultivation of eggplants, it's crucial to associate them wisely with other vegetables, as they have both beneficial companions and potential adversaries. Proximity to other vegetables plays a crucial role in the success or failure of eggplant cultivation. Eggplants thrive in the presence of tarragon, beans, parsley, bell peppers, peas, thyme, tomatoes, leeks, and radishes. Phacelia, a bee-friendly plant, attracts pollinators, promoting the formation and development of fruits. Marigolds have a reputation for repelling aphids. Eggplant does not thrive in the presence of onions and potatoes. Nine. Harvest storage. The harvest of eggplants typically occurs around 5 months after planting, though this timing can vary based on the climate and growing conditions. The harvest period spans from summer to fall, depending on the seeding or planting period. Harvesting is done gradually as needed, ideally before complete ripening to avoid potential bitterness in the flesh. It is advisable to consume eggplants promptly. In terms of storage, they can be kept for approximately 1 week in the vegetable crisper of the refrigerator. A good indicator for determining the right time to pick them is when the fruit stops growing, and the skin becomes thin and slightly glossy. At this point, you can use pruning shears to cut the stem for a faster healing process. 10. This video is now concluded. Thank you for watching it until the end, hoping that you enjoyed it. If that's the case, don't forget to subscribe and leave a comment. You might be selected for the giveaway, where I'll be giving away organic vegetable seeds to one of you. Also, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. I appreciate it in advance. With that, I'll see you very soon in the next video. Bye.